TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Surabhi Sharma. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 26th of December. Ring of Fire, Eclipse and Thrall Sky Watchers in India, Sri Lanka. Pakistan government files review petition in Army Chief Extension case. And Indian couple devotes life to orphans after losing children to 2004 tsunami. And now for all the details. People all across the world, including India, Sri Lanka and Nepal, witnessed the last solar eclipse of the decade on Thursday. The annular solar eclipse occurs when the moon covers the sun's center, leaving the sun's visible outer edges to form a ring of fire around the moon. People all across the world, including India, witnessed the last solar eclipse of the decade on Thursday. The annular solar eclipse occurs when the moon covers the sun's center, leaving the sun's visible outer edges to form a ring of fire around the moon. In India, the partial eclipse began at 8 a.m. and ended at 11:16 a.m., while the greatest eclipse started at 9:30 a.m. Fog blocked the view of solar eclipse in capital New Delhi, but people, including school children in the western and southern parts of the country, were able to watch the rare celestial spectacle.
Moon is actually coming in between the sun and earth, and that is how we sense, I mean, the eclipses. So we were in fact between earth, moon, we were between earth. So this eclipse which we viewed was from a bit, we went in fact in a space, I mean, at a height altitude about 21,000 feet. And that is where we could sense that, yes, so we are somewhere between earth and moon.
In Sri Lanka, students at Colombo University's Astronomical Society set up their telescopes early on Thursday to see the solar eclipse. The eclipse was best visible in northern Jaffna, where 87% of the sun was covered by the moon, and in Colombo, about 84% of the sun was eclipsed. Sri Lankans were spellbound by the celestial event.
Jaffna, you can see annual eclipse. Now here we are at Colombo University. In Colombo University, we are under penumbra. That means lighter shadow, so we can see only partial eclipse.
Meanwhile, students from various Nepali schools and universities flocked capital Kathmandu's BP Koirala Memorial Planetarium, Observatory and Science Museum on Thursday, as the observatory had made special arrangements to view the solar eclipse through a telescope directly. Sky watchers witnessed the eclipse through solar filter fitted telescope to support cultivating scientific conscience and culture among the people. The annular eclipse started from Dammam in Saudi Arabia and travelled across Indian Ocean towards southern India and over the northern part of Sri Lanka and ended above the Pacific Ocean. Moving on, the Pakistan government has filed a review petition on Army Chief General Qamar Javed Bajwa's tenure extension and has sought a larger bench to hear the matter. The government said the Supreme Court's verdict last month to grant a conditional extension of only 6 months to Bajwa had several legal gaps. The top court in its verdict had said the parliament was to decide on his further tenure while suspending the government's decision to extend the tenure for 3 years. The top court has cited a series of irregularities and ordered the government and the army to produce legal provisions and detailed arguments for the 3-year extension. The Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz has demanded resignation of Narcotics Control Minister Shehryar Afridi for levelling what is said false allegations against party leader and former Punjab Law Minister Rana Sanaullah.
The Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz or PMLN has called for resignation of Shehryar Afridi, Pakistan's Minister of State for Narcotics Control, for implicating party leader and Punjab's former law minister Rana Sanaullah in what it called a false narcotics case. PMLN spokesperson Mariam Aurangzeb said on Wednesday that as the Lahore High Court has granted bail to Rana Sanaullah, Afridi should resign forthwith as his design in this respect has been exposed. She said the government failed to prove the allegations leveled against Sanaullah and said the ruling PTI during its 15-month term had only arrested its political rivals in false cases to show its performance, which has remained zero in every other front. Rana Sanaullah had been in detention for over 6 months. He was arrested in July while he was travelling from Faisalabad to Lahore. Anti-narcotics force officials claim to have seized 15 kilograms of heroin from his vehicle. Five others, including his driver and security guard, were also nabbed.
In news from Afghanistan, the Afghan government has made headway in the war on insurgency in the country as security forces recaptured several districts in crackdowns on armed groups in 2019 to expand its sovereignty. The Afghan government, contrary to past years, have made headway in the war on insurgency as government forces have expelled armed insurgents from 11 districts throughout the outgoing year to expand its sovereignty. According to the Afghan Defense Ministry, security forces recaptured several Taliban-controlled districts in the northern Badakhshan province in September and October, forcing Taliban fighters to flee or surrender in the region where it ruled for 4 years. The security forces also recaptured several areas in Kunduz, Faryab, Baghlan, Helmand and Ghazni provinces in 2019. Meanwhile, in November this year, Afghan President Ashraf Ghani claimed security forces have obliterated the Islamic State militant group in the country's Nangarhar province, which long served as the main stronghold of the militant group. Officials said airstrikes by Afghan and coalition forces, lack of funds and low morale forced the group to give up as more than 600 fighters surrendered to the Afghan government in just a few weeks. In news from Nepal, after withdrawal of Socialist Party Nepal, the Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli-led government has lost its two-third majority in the parliament. Chairman of Socialist Party Nepal, Upendra Yadav, said on Wednesday that he resigned from the post of Deputy Prime Minister due to Oli's continued reluctance to amend the constitution.
The Socialist Party Nepal on Wednesday withdrew its support from Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli-led government, a day after the party's chief Upendra Yadav resigned from the post of the country's Deputy Prime Minister. The Socialist Party Nepal decided to withdraw its support, accusing Prime Minister Oli of failing to keep the pre-alliance agreement of constitution amendment. Yadav in a press meet claimed that his party will not give up the issue of the constitutional amendment but will fight for it from the parliament as well as the roads in the coming days.
हामीले त संविधान संशोधन गर्ने शर्तमा सरकारमा सहभागी भएको त्यो नै नहुने भइसकेपछि हामीले चाहिँ के जोनी यहाँले गाउँथे छ हामी सरकारमा सहभागी रहेका दुई जनाले राजीनामा गर्यौ र आज हामीले हाम्रो पार्टीले केन्द्रीय कार्यकारिणी समिति बसेर चाहिँ के भने अब आज देखि नेकपा को सरकारलाई केपी शर्मा ओली नेतृत्वको सरकारलाई दिँदै आएको समर्थन पार्टीले फिर्ता लिएको छ र अब हाम्रो पार्टी समाजवादी पार्टी प्रतिपक्षमा रहेर प्रतिपक्षको भूमिका निर्वाह गर्ने निर्णय गरेको यहाँहरूलाई जानकारी गराउन चाहन्छु.
Oli's ruling Nepal Communist Party is now left with 174 seats, 9 short of two-third majority. Earlier, the Rashtriya Janata Party or RJPN had also withdrawn its support to Oli government.
Communities across Asia remembered thousands of victims of the Indian Ocean tsunami on Thursday, on the 15th anniversary of the deadly disaster. Inspiring many around the world, a couple in southern India that lost all three of their children in the 2004 tsunami have been running a shelter for the children orphaned by the disaster.
A couple in southern India that lost all three of their children in the deadly 2004 tsunami has turned the grief into a beacon of hope. Parmeswaran and his wife Chudamani have been running a shelter named Nambikei, meaning hands of hope, for the children orphaned by the disaster. Parmeswaran and Chudamani lost their two daughters and a son, along with seven other close family members, on the fateful morning of December 26 in 2004.
They have lost the children, parents, and they didn't have the hope to live. No? They were just literally crying on the road. And then I thought, like, see, I lost my children. And why not I take these children and give them shelter?
Wherever the parentless children, we want to give them their life. Because we know that if instead of my children, we parents would have been died, my children would have been the orphans. So we don't want to make any orphans in the road. So this mission will continue for a lifetime till the earth is moving.
Many of the older children from the orphanage have moved out and are pursuing higher education or are working, with some joining multinational companies. But their connection with the Nambikei shelter remains strong. Of the more than 12,000 people who died in the 2004 tsunami in India, more than 6,000 of them were from the southern Nagapattinam alone. The disaster killed a total of more than 230,000 people in Indonesia, Sri Lanka, India, Thailand and 9 other countries.
Tourists visiting India's hill province of Himachal Pradesh to witness snowfall this winter can now also enjoy a ride of the country's first narrow-gauge train with translucent ceiling. The train with glass ceiling enables the passengers to enjoy views of mountains and skies together.
Locals as well as tourists visiting India's northern Himachal Pradesh province can now enjoy rides on the country's first narrow-gauge train with translucent ceiling. The train, which has seven coaches, was decked up on Wednesday for its first ride from Kalka railway station to its final destination of Shimla town. The tourists said they were elated with the experience of the journey, where they could enjoy the views from the windows and the see-through ceilings called the vista domes, providing the view of the skies.
The way they have made it, they have made the arrangement for AC and all that, and the top dome is transparent, and you can have the view of the sky also, and the windows are very good, I would say. The seating arrangement is good.
It was fantastic. I've never been on anything like this before, especially with the views. They're so gorgeous. It was also very comfortable, a comfortable train even though small.
Famed for its panoramic views as it climbs more than 4,000 feet through heritage tunnels and along multi-arch bridges, the narrow-gauge 96-kilometer Kalka to Shimla route is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. The line, known affectionately as the Toy Train Line, was opened in the year 1903 to connect Shimla, the summer capital under British colonial rule, to the North Indian plains.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. Ring of Fire eclipse enthralls sky watchers in India, Sri Lanka. Pakistan government files review petition in Army Chief extension case. And Indian couple devotes life to orphans after losing children to 2004 tsunami. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline. And follow us on Twitter at @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.